so much violence in downtown St. Louis. Mm-hmm. You're homeless yourself. Excuse me.
But let me say something. No, I'm not homeless. Uh-huh. I just like helping this city get a better place.
Do you really?
Help them stop all this killing. It make no sense.
Yeah, so you're sick and tired of it.
Yeah, I'm fed up with all that stuff they doing out there, killing up people.
You are facing a lot of needs yourself, though, but you see this is a great big need, right?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, well, right behind us, there's a march taking place, and actually citizens that are marching right now for peace in the city. But what we really need is prayer, it seems like. We got to call on God.
Yeah, I know.
How many? It took 10 plagues to break Pharaoh. How many plagues is it going to take for this country to humble itself before God and say, we need you, God?
Well, I'm not sure when these people going to wake up, but I will say this, I'm all for peace because they need to get this killing and violence to stop. Then this will be a much better city than what it is now.
There's so much violence
right
now.
Yeah, I know. And I don't like to see people be shot. I don't like to see nobody be killed either. I don't like none of that. So I'm with them people. They want to stop the violence.
Yes.
I agree with them people that participate in that too, to stop all this violence.
Yeah.
It just don't make no sense. They killing up people. That don't make no sense.
So many killings taking place.
It's sad.
Paper described downtown St. Louis as the wild, wild west.
That's what they say. That's what they say.
We also need to understand that, you know, we need prayer at this time. And
people need prayer. That's what they need.
And they got to stop shutting down like the church at 1411 Locust and get the word of God and shut down
that
last shelter.
I want to say, they need to open that church back up. They need to get that church open back up for people to get help when they need it.
Yes.
I'm all for that.
Yes. So now, anyway, behind us now, people are trying to do whatever they can to bring forth peace. I see that. But we really need a lot of prayer in this city.
Yeah.
And as we indicate, if they shut down the churches like they did at 1411 Locust, you get whatever person also plants that soil for reap, or should I say.
That's true.
All right. Well, brother, we're going to keep you in prayer. And if there's anything we can help you with, you let us know, all right?
I will.
And we thank God for, the fact that there are people who are standing up for peace at this time.
And I agree with them people. I'm for peace, too.
Yes.
All that killing and shooting, all that need to stop. That just don't make no sense. That's sad.
And so we're addressing this issue as we prepare to go to the streets with the love of God, feeding the hungry, reaching out, offering help to the homeless in the form of shelter, hygiene kits, masks, and so many words.
I'm for that.
Yes,
I'm for helping those people that don't got nowhere to go, but I feel for them.
So there are a lot of people in need right now.
This city's my home.
And it grieves you to see all the violence that's going on right now.
Yeah.
So a lot of issues we're facing. Violence big time in downtown St. Louis. Coronavirus sweeping this area. The coronavirus starting to sweep Springfield right now. But they have like over 200 students just at Southwestern Missouri State University that have been testing positive. The needs are great. We're going to go to the streets right now. Individuals in the city are going to the streets with the message of we need peace in this city right now. We need peace.
Yeah.
David? The message is going out. Looks like they got that going. But you live in downtown St. Louis.
I see
a lot of this stuff, a lot of things going on.
I do.
Well, we really, really need to pray. And, you know, the Bible says whatever a person sows, that shall also reap. Shutting down the church at 1411 Locust, which hold up the word of God, putting the people out on the streets. We just need prayer in this city, don't we?
Absolutely. And the influx of violence, as ironic as it is, it's not, the majority of it is not due to our St. Louis homeless. It's all the people coming from the outlying counties, Illinois, the people, the indigent people here in downtown St. Louis, they're basically just looking for shelter. They're not causing trouble, trouble on this magnitude, which this peace march is representing.
Yes.
The violence, the shooting, the rampant speeding of downtown St. Louis, you know?
Yeah.
If the homeless had cars, I don't think they'd be speeding. You'd be going elsewhere, I'm sure. You know, interject a little humor to overshadow the hypocrisy of what this city has done to our homeless.
Yeah, it is. And people are hurting, and it seems like what they do is the rich and powerful move in. They want to push them out of sight, out of mind. 3 years ago, they were blaming the homeless. They shut down the place, and things have only gotten worse.
Absolutely, absolutely. And now, as it is, now the homeless down here are victims of outside violence.
Yes.
You know? Not only do they...
I noticed that, to
avoid all the violence that's going on down here.
Right. Well, there are citizens that are marching in behalf of peace in the city. We need citizens praying. We got to call out unto God. We need to humble ourselves before God and say, Lord, have mercy on us as a community. We ask you to forgive us, Lord, for our sins, Lord God. And we ask that you'd come and let there be peace in our community. And, and we want to be instruments of peace as we go forth, sharing the love of God, sharing food to the hungry.
Absolutely.
And reaching out and helping those in need.
Absolutely. And without the support of donorship coming in, we wouldn't be enabled to do this.
Amen. So as people march for peace, we are going to be moving forth to the streets, taking food and calling people to prayer at this time. We need really prayer. We need people praying at this time. We need people reaching out through the love of Christ. And we need all of you at this moment, just letting the love and power of God work through you. You can partner with us by contacting us at the New Life Evangelistic Center as we take the Word of God to those that are in need, distributing food and clothing and hygiene items and blankets, and as we pray for peace in our community. So many people out that are out here, and it's cold water. And cold water means a lot when there's all the water fountains are closed. So we're out here in our own peace march, feeding the hungry with bags of food. And this is being done because of all of you, wonderful, wonderful people that are praying and partnering with the New Life Evangelistic Center, so we can just go right among the people, letting people know that there's hope. Christ is risen. We want people to come to know the love and power of God. So many, many people in need. A bottle of cold water means so much when somebody's homeless, somebody's in need. And you make it all possible, all of you that are sharing with the New Life Evangelistic Center at this particular hour. And then for those that are sleeping outside, let me see what I got here for blankets. Oh, there's some nice blankets I thank God for. People that are sleeping out. You need a pillow too?
I need two blankets.
Oh, I got one here. I got to give one to everybody here.
I probably got to lay one down.
Let me see if I got a sheet for you. Anybody else need a blanket? See what I got left here, because I'll spread them out to as many as I can.
Give me that pillow right there, Larry.
You want a pillow?
All right. Get on there. Get on right there.
Yeah, you want a pillow here. Okay, here's a... All right, there you go. God bless you. Anybody else need a blanket? So many people out right now. There you are. How are you today?
Man.
There you go. Jesus loves you.
Thank you.
Uh-huh. What is that?
Get pillows?
Yes, you got one. I got a pillow left here. You sleeping outside? Hey, but what about here? I got some cardboard.
Look at that cardboard, Larry.
Oh, you want the cardboard? No, I can't. You can't even buy tents anymore.
Damn.
Yeah, they're all out of. You can't even buy a tent anymore. I mean, you're coming out of China, and things are getting cut off there, and trade wars are getting rough, and a lot of people in need. So, a lot of people in need. Let's see. I got two more blankets here. You need a blanket? You need a blanket? What's that?
Y'all need no blanket.
All right. I know some people around behind me over here that do, so I'll hang on. Thanks for your honesty. God bless you all. How's that cold water feel?
Good.
You need some more? I'll get you another case out if I need to. Got to keep people in water. It's hard to get water these days.
Yeah, it is.
All water fountains closed. Fast food restaurants closed. Everything closed.
Right.
All right. Let me see if I can maybe grab another case out of here. A lot of people that are in need right now. See if we get... Oh, yes. I promised you that if I had one left, I'd get you one. Well, here it is. There you are. Yes. Thank you. And God bless you. David, see if we need any more water out. We can put another case of water out if we have to. And again, I can't say enough to all of you that are reaching out through the love of Christ, just really letting God's light and love shine through you. It's hard for people that are having to sleep outside right now. But that's thing. I got one left. You sleeping outside? You need it? Here, I'll give you the bag and everything.
All right, thanks, sir.
How you doing?
Bless
you. You too. All right. I got it. Yes, that's what we need right now. Too much violence out on these streets. We got to share that there's hope, and that's what we're out here in the middle of the homeless camps doing. Sharing there's hope. Christ is risen, giving people a chance to just know that God loves them. How are you? There's some ice water over here for you. Yes, a lot of people out on the streets right now, and it's our first of our stops. And we're going to continue to reach out through love of Christ, sharing that there can be peace, helping people to come to know Him as their Lord and Savior, and demonstrating the love of Christ. He fed the multitudes. He's the river, He's the waters, the living waters. I want to remind everyone that it's God's love that blankets and encourages and comforts and strengthens them in the hour of need. So, hey, we're only able to bow here because of all of your prayers, your involvement. I want to thank the folks from Concord Baptist and our friends there that gathered up all these sandwiches that they get to us once a month. Others that are bringing them by, 2428 Woodson Road in Overland, Missouri. Karen Giesen, thank you for helping put that together. And all the rest of you that are right out there on the front lines, letting the love of Christ flow through you.
This is Kiki. She was homeless in Overland.
Hi, Kiki. How are you? Kiki? All right. What does this cold water and stuff mean to you, Kiki?
It means everything to me. It's good to know that there's good people still in this world.
Kiki, if you want to get involved in one of our safe houses, you let us know, okay?
Okay. How do I do that?
Let's talk to David right over here, okay?
Okay.
And David, Pastor Ray, myself, we'll see about getting you off these streets because it's hard out here, isn't it?
Yeah, most definitely.
Doesn't it wear you down after a
while? It does.
Day after day?
Takes a toll on you.
Oh, yes. Well, let's try to get you off the streets. And what you do is you move in with some of our other ladies that were previously homeless. They'll have a chance to minister to you, comfort you. There's usually anywhere from 2 to 5 in the house, so it's small places.
Okay.
And talk to David about it just a moment over here, okay?
Okay.
And I'll be happy to talk to you in just a minute.
Okay.
David, she'd like to talk to you about her safe house, and you and Ray catch up. Again, wow, there's so many opportunities because of all of you that are letting your light and love shine, that are just really right out here in the middle of the streets. Yes, it can. There's a lot of violence out here, but, you know, the perfect love of God casts out the fear, the violence, the hatred, the bitterness. So we've got to let our light so shine before men and women they may see our good works and glorify our Father who's in heaven. And that's the opportunity that you give us as you pray for us here at the New Life Evangelistic Center, and as you let the light and love of Christ shine in you and through you. So again, get directly involved, and God bless you, brother, and I want you to know that the Lord loves you. I know it's hard.
I got a question for you.
Sure, yeah.
I got a bunch of stuff, and I never can make it up to City Hall.
Yeah.
So maybe if you got some bus tickets, because I never make it up
there.
I
don't have with me right now, but if you want to talk to them right now to see if Pastor Ray will be out tonight with them, okay?
Okay.
But we had so many people that came down there for that.
Okay.
That I'd have to see if we're going to have to order some more or not, okay?
Oh, okay.
I mean, we're just so many people end up on these streets now as a result of this COVID, you know? And I was just shocked at the number of people that showed up for that transportation distribution.
Right. So I just don't want nobody stealing my stuff.
Well, maybe you can team up with somebody and keep an eye out and do something with you. But what was your name?
August.
We'll keep you in prayer. How'd you ever end up out on the streets?
Take me in September.
Well, I was released from the St. Louis County Justice Center, and
they didn't give you any place to go.
No, they just released me.
Hey, talk to our staff about our residential leadership program. Place for you to live, place for you to work, place for you to develop a work record, and help you to start all over again. You should do that, okay?
Okay.
It's our residential program. People come where they live, they work together, develop a work record, and a whole new beginning, okay?
Okay.
So let's see if we can help you do that, all right?
Right.
So that's even more valuable to you than all these other things.
Yeah.
So that's what we're going to do, is help set the homeless men, women, families, children off the streets. Yes, Jesus has come to set the captives free. We're going to continue our journey, sharing the good news. There's hope. Christ is risen. out here trying to hand out. All right, here's a nice mask for you, sir. And they've got food over here for you, too.
You got food and water?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
A nice ice water over there. Let's get some ice water out here.
Hey,
is there any possible chance that you can purchase a tent?
I've gone everywhere. If anybody knows where I can purchase a tent, I wish they'd sure tell me. I've looked everywhere for tents, okay?
Did you go to Walmart?
Yes. I've been about 4 or 5 of them, okay? And you go in the sporting department, and they say they can't even get them anymore because they're all, this embargo in China.
It's a bargain in China?
China. The big embargo.
Okay, so
look at these masks go, folks. God bless you all.
So therefore, we can't get a tent.
I'm gonna keep looking. I'm not gonna give up. But I need you praying. I need my Facebook friends praying. I mean my NLEC TV sharing. Okay, come over and get some ice water here too. But if anybody got a tent they're not using, anybody know where there's a tent? Please help us get some tents here. We got some ice water back here for you. Food back here. God bless you, brother.
God bless you too, brother.
Let's have peace, right?
Yeah.
All right, we're sharing the peace and the love of Jesus. Yes, sir. Here you are.
Yes, sir.
Yes, he does. Jesus, our living water, is what he is. And sister, let me tell you. Some of our friends moved out from the riverfront. There may be some abandoned tents down there if you ever want to get down there and try to look down there.
Yes, sir.
I saw some.
Mm-hmm.
So we're repossessing those. We're trying to get people to give us tents that might have them. I've been, like I said, I don't know how many. I've counted them. I've been to them in Warrenton, Osage Beach, Columbia.
Uh-huh.
And I'm just telling you how many stores I've gone to, okay?
Oh, wow.
St. Louis.
Wow.
I've been looking for 3 weeks, and every one of them say they can't even get them anymore, okay?
Oh, yes, sir.
That's the untold story. How are you doing? You doing all right there? They can't even get them anymore, okay?
I'm sorry to hear that, sir, but I'm really in need of a tent.
We got to find you one. What else do you need?
I just really, like I said, need a home, actually. Yes, sir. So right now I need a tent.
Can we maybe get into one of our safe houses?
Where is that located, sir?
We have them. Some in the city, we have some out in the county,
mm-hmm.
and they're like.
So how do you go about?
We'll talk to him. Okay. They'll be out tonight,
okay.
And then let them know where they find you. Okay.
All right. Yes, sir.
Let's do that. All right.
Yes, sir. And, God bless you.
Can I give you? I've got some Bible studies. I want you to help me give out. Can I do that?
Oh, yes.
You want to come here with me? Yes. How are you? Look at this one here. Isn't that a pretty one?
Yes.
How are you?
I have a big handful of them.
I'm looking here to see where he's got them. Oh, here they are. All right, well, here they are. We'll try to get these out to the people here. The Word of God, we not only want to give them physical needs, but here you go.
Hey, Reverend, I missed getting tickets yesterday morning. I had to go.
Okay, well, like I said, we had more people than we anticipated yesterday.
Oh, really?
Yeah, we're going to have to order more. And we just, there's a great run on right now.
Mm-hmm.
People needing transportation assistance, water, food. I mean, so many people end up homeless because of this whole coronavirus thing.
Right.
Okay?
Mm-hmm. So yeah, you're doing a good job. Keep it up, Reverend.
We're trying. We really are. A lot of people in need. Lots of people in need. Here you are.
We got waters in the
bags. Waters in the bags. Okay. Wow. Look, all up and down the street here, there's people that are homeless, people that are in need, just all the way down the street here. And we're asking all of you to keep us in prayer. They're sleeping over there behind the building. The city puts up fences to keep them out, but they have to have some place to lay their head at night, some place to lay their head. No wonder there's violence in this city as they shut down the last major walk-in shelter, 1411 Locust, refused to let it be opened back up again, forcing people to live like animals. But yet these people continue day after day, just continue to trust God, continue to persevere. And these are human beings made in the image of God. So many, many people that are in need right now. And people are really in need. You need some cold water, or if you need some food, there's some up there. All righty. So many, many people out now, right now. Come on, folks, we need you praying. It's good they're marching, but they got to do more than march. We got to put some legs to our prayers. We got to put some hands to our prayers. We got to do what Jesus told us to do. He said, when I was hungry, did you feed me? Naked, did you clothe me? Sick or in prison, you visit me? A stranger, homeless, did you welcome me? And they shut down the last major walk-in shelter in downtown St. Louis. No wonder the wrath of God has fallen on this city. I'm asking you to pray for it, please. Pray for it. That's just one of a multitude of different reasons. Like I said, it took 10 plagues to bring Pharaoh to his knees. How many will it take this city? How many more will it take this country right now? Yes, we need a major change right now. We don't need more divisiveness. We need more unity. We need more love. We need more of God. People shouldn't have to continue to just live up and down the streets, falling on the sidewalks, wherever they can. People living here, trying to survive everywhere that they can. excuse me, just so many, many people. people back there, sleeping back there, people over here, all over. All right. Well, I'm asking you to continue to pray for us. We're going to continue to reach out to the people. And I'm just asking you to just continue to let God's light and love shine in you and through you. Well, I'm right out here on the streets with some of the folks that are working hard. Tell us how you're working hard.
Definitely, yeah. Just getting started this morning, but I have a feeling it's going to be a nice long day, so.
Hey, I was driving along, and you just reminded me, I got to get my mask on.
Okay, yeah, I'm glad to see you got yours on.
Yeah,
that's great.
Safety first, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Never be too safe.
If you need a clean one.
Yeah, I always accept extra masks. You can never have too many.
Out here, you hold a sign up or something?
Yeah, I hold a sign asking people to help. Yes, sir.
Anything is a blessing. Every little bit helps. Water, food, clothes, even just a prayer. Thanks.
Yeah.
What's your first name?
I'm Kayla.
All right, let's remember to keep Kayla in prayer. Folks, will you remember Kayla in prayer? Kayla, how did you end up out here?
Honestly, I just made a lot of bad mistakes, you know. Same old story. I fell in love with the wrong guy, and everything just went downhill.
Did you ever think it'd be like this?
No, growing up, I never did. You know, you always saw those people. I was one of those people that used to go by and hand out money to the people on the streets, and I never thought I would end up being on the other side of it.
It's truly more blessed to be able to give than to have to ask to receive.
Yes, sir. Even now, still being on the streets myself, if I make extra money and I see somebody else that needs something, we give to each other. We still try to help out.
Okay, I want to get you a new sleeping bag here, and I thank God for people that donate to us. What do you think of that?
Oh, yeah, thank you. You're always a blessing.
Is that a blessing for you?
Oh, yes, more than a blessing. Blankets that you sleep on, they tend to get dirty pretty easily.
Do they really?
And yes, sir.
Would you like this mask?
Yes, please. Thank you.
Here, let me give you a few scriptures. Somebody may want to help you, and then you may want to pass the word of the Lord on to them, too, okay?
Oh, I always love reading the word of the Lord.
All right. Well,
always
a couple of them for you.
Thank you.
And then I want to get you something to eat. Where'd you sleep last night?
Underneath a bridge, underneath the highway.
What'd you sleep on?
I slept on a thin blanket on gravel. Yes, sir. Yeah, sometimes you can get a piece of cardboard to, you know, soften the blow a little bit, but with all the rain that's been going through and, you know, if trash gets cleaned up, then you don't have cardboard to pick through.
So what does a sleeping bag mean to you?
Honestly, it means that I get to sleep in some kind of comfort. You know what I mean? I don't have to worry about bugs crawling all over me for once.
We're going to go and talk to some more of the people working out here right now, but thank you. Let me give you a bag of water and food here. A bag with some water and some food in it.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Yeah, so cold water on a day like today.
There it is, and there's some food for you, okay?
Thank you.
And we want to say thank you to all the people that donate. I don't think people realize how much it means.
It means the world to us. Honestly, even just a kind word or just even a hello means the world to us.
Okay, I see you back over here. We got some people. You walk up and down the line, people pull up at a light, what kind of responses do you get?
Honestly, I've had a lot of good responses. You know, I have people that say they'll pray for me and, you know, just hope for the best for me. You know, some people pull up and they give you papers and stuff like that. You know, they have the shelters and all that. You know, just a lot of them are closed down right now. There are people out there that, you know, do try to help us. It's just
a lot of sincere people think that, well, here's this shelter with these names on it. When you get right in, it's not like that.
You have to wait for somebody else that was on the streets, you know, to want to go back on the streets or by the grace of God, find somewhere else to go.
If you ever want to get into one of the safe houses we have out in the county, okay?
Yes.
And a couple in the city. And in the meantime, we're going to do everything you can to help you right here where you're at, all right?
Well, we appreciate that.
You know how much Jesus loves you.
Oh, don't I know it?
Tell
every day.
Your first name again so they pray for you.
I'm Kayla.
Remember Kayla in your prayers. Remember Kayla in your prayers. Well, we're going to continue to keep walking along here. And Kayla, God bless you. And I'm glad that helps you, okay?
Thank you. And bless you, too. Thank you guys for all that you do out here for us. Like I said, even just a kind word and getting to have a nice conversation means the world on certain days, you know?
A lot of times people just pass you by if they know you're homeless.
They kind of act like you almost have, you know, some kind of a disease that they can catch. You know, they try to avoid you at any cost if they can.
Remember that. You see them out here, stop lying to yourself that everybody that's out here just trying to collect money for drugs or alcohol. No. a lot of them are just trying to exist. There's one couple out here that I'm going to see if I can catch up with that. Wow, if they don't get enough money every day, they're out on the streets. They try to get enough to get in a hotel room.
Yes, sir. That's usually most of our goals, yeah.
They're really hard, and they don't always reach those goals. That's why we're trying to give them these other supplies. So please pray for us as we're working to be out here when the people are hurting. Trying to get a dollar here, a dollar there, enough so you can get a hotel room. I'm right out here with the people that are trying to do that, offering people. Here comes a man. You have your sign? Your sign. What does it say? Oh, okay. It says, homeless, please help out here trying to survive. Let me get you a sleeping bag, okay? Tell me a little bit about what's it like doing this day after day. I think it's a lot of hard work, isn't it?
Yeah.
It is a lot of hard work. Here you go. Here's a lunch for you, too. Let me dig that out of here for you. Now, what kind of response are you getting from people? Are people helping you quite a bit?
Yeah.
All right, here, let me give you another one, too. I'm sure you got a water.
Yeah, people real nice to me, man.
Is it?
Yeah.
Now, here you go. Take this water for you, okay?
All right.
What is your first name?
Tyrone.
Tyrone. We'll keep you in prayer then, okay? Yeah. And you go ahead and let me see if I can find a dollar for you here, Tyrone, okay?
Yes, sir.
Because I know you've been working out here hard. I'm about down to, I think I got one left now. So, Lord bless you, Tyrone.
God bless you, too.
All right. Well, you go ahead and keep doing what you're doing, okay?
Yes, sir.
And you folks continue to understand what it's like. So many people that have so many different impressions that are wrong. Hi, how are you?
Good. To you or to the organization, I don't know.
You need help yourself?
No. I need to give something.
Oh, you want to give it. Well, I'm giving it right out to the people here, but if you want to bring it, you bring it to 2428 Woodson Road.
Okay, you think that I can reach you?
What's that?
Where can I drop you?
Here in Overland. That's our new headquarters at 2428 Woodson, okay?
Okay,
and we gather up the items and we take them to all the homeless that are all over like this, okay?
Okay, do you take the cooked food or?
Uncooked, we prefer.
Good. That's what we are planning on.
Any phone number?
421-3020.
3020 in 314?
Yes, 314. We couldn't do it without caring people like you, because we don't receive any government funding.
Sir?
I'm Larry Rice.
Larry Rice, my name is Manny. Thank you.
Nice to meet you, sir. Have a good day. Well, you see how the Lord provides for not only the homeless out here, but all of us as we're trying to help them. This is a reality show, folks, and you're a part of it, as we're trying to just get out here among the people that normally are forgotten. God bless you. They're out here on every corner and won't be able to get around to all of them because you have to go all the way across that intersection to get some more. But you see them all over, and prayerfully the politicians will, instead of just running them off, will try to do what they can to help the homeless. A lot of homeless people out here that are in need, and we're out here meeting them, helping them, just trying to meet. How are you today? A lot of people just out here. We may not be able to get to all of them today, but I'm asking you to please just let God's light and love shine through you as we're trying to reach out among the hurting and the homeless. Every day, how much do you have to get in order to have a place to sleep
$30.
At night? You found a room for $30?
Yeah, on Green and Page.
So you found a room, but if people don't give that $30, then you have to sleep out. Is that right?
We always do.
So you make it. So here, let's add that to it.
Okay.
I had one, and I even got one off my cameraman, okay?
Thank you.
Tell me your name.
Alexa.
Alexa, what kind of response do you get when you ask people out here? And hold up, I barely can read your sign. It looks like you need to make a new one, don't you?
Yeah.
Just homeless, please help us. What kind of response do you get?
I get good response.
Do most of people help you?
Have bad.
So most of people really help you?
Mm-hmm.
That's a blessing. Seems like there's more and more people out here on the streets at this time, doesn't it?
Yes, sir.
So many that are hurting out on the streets. I know you're trying to get a room every night, but try to take a clean sleeping bag to that room.
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yeah.
All right. Well, I thank God for those that donate, because if it wasn't for caring people that donated, we could not do this. We don't receive any city, state, or federal dollars. No United Way dollars. And then I also got a bag of food here for you, too, okay? Here you are. And there's some food and water over here for you. Food and water. So you got to be sure you don't go hungry today, okay?
Okay.
It's hard work out here doing this, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Hard work. And more people, don't be surprised if you see more and more folks out on the streets doing this with this COVID-19. It just putting people out of work, and people are losing their jobs.
We got masks,
glasses in it?
Oh, you'd like a mask. I have one somewhere here. I'm glad you asked me. We'll get you a nice clean mask, okay? So many, many people are in need right now. I dig down the bottom of my bag here, and I'm just carrying this bag all over here, trying to find this stuff. Here's some. And then here, I even got a word of the Lord for you, okay? There you go. Looks like you're ready to go to eat some of that food, aren't you?
You should.
All right, well, here you go. Look. Nice mask. You want this one right here?
I want that red one.
You want the red one.
Yeah, I want the red one, too. Can I get a red one?
You got matching masks, right?
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
And I thank God, and I say thank you to all of you that are helping us with the masks, with the food, water. Oh, we need a lot of water. We go through so much water every day. It's hard to find water when you're out.
Yeah.
Water fountains closed to fast food restaurants they can't walk into.
They can't go to the bathroom.
There's no place to go to the bathroom.
Yeah, you're out here.
People don't understand how hard it is, right?
Yeah.
Being homeless on the streets at this time. So what New Life is doing is going out among the hurting, the most hurting and needy people that are out there. And I was indicating to a couple that drove up that if you want to help, you can bring those sandwiches we urgently need, sandwiches, food items to 2428 Woodson Road in Overland, Missouri, 806 North Jefferson in Springfield. You can send the gifts so we can share it with those that are in need with New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, that's 63166. And please let the light and love of Christ shine through you. To get more information on all this, go to NLEC TV or go to NLEC. Go to NLEC at the website we have, the Facebook page, continue to follow, okay, .org or NewLifeEvangelisticCenter.org. So please let your light shine and get directly involved right now.